Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. It's currently the 14th of May, 3303, and we're still on the way to the Earth, orbiting the neutron star. And I've been kind of thinking a few things change on board ship. So, unfortunately, I've opted out turning on the voice command, turning on Vega's little box, because there's some strange things going on and I don't clearly understand what's going on. So I've been looking at fixing Vega, or that system in general, but I've also been looking at these HUD colors. Now this is the default HUD color. I've been looking at it for like a few years now, and I'm getting tired of it. Unfortunately,
frameshift drive charging.
It's not unfortunate. It's quote unquote a very easy fix. It's just changing some numbers in the configuration of the OS. Unfortunately, there's no real building system to change color, so I fiddled around with a program that's on my editing computer. Yeah, I thought I had something very nice and I tried it and I hated it. So I'm still looking at changing the color of the HUD, but for now it will remain this quite bland orange. Okay, and with that, we are going into the time lapse. We'll see how far we get close enough to the Earth, to the Earth-like orbiting the neutron. I hope to get there today. Thank you. into the system, which has the Earth-like orbiting really close by. For those who have been paying attention, they might notice the time frame, the time stamp in the time lapse doesn't add up. Let's avoid that plasma, shall we? Okay. Which planet is it? It's number 2. That's number 3. That's number 1. Okay. That's 3. Oh, wait. Got it bookmarked. Okay, I have to pay attention. Let's slow down. See that the neutron star is behind me. Yep. It's now, well, it's right of me. There in a minute. Okay, so yeah, we have now completed the second leg of the journey. Next destination is going to be Sagittarius A, which is the massive black hole within the center of our galaxy. After that, it's Beagle Point. After that, after Beagle Point, when we're back from Beagle Point, we're going to start surveying planets. It's near, we're going to survey systems in the northeastern quadrant of our galaxy. And we are going to look for a place that, we're looking for home. I'm looking for home, so, and I believe the home I'm looking for is somewhere in the northeastern part of the galaxy. But let's first slow down. Okay, there's the planet. Kind of want to end this with a shot. Okay. That has to be cold. It's like 2 degrees Celsius across the entire planet. So, but that's the average temperature. So it's a very cold planet. Probably a lot of radiation as well. But life probably very, very much adapted to orbit around the neutron star. Okay, slowing down. And we have dropped our Super Bruce. And we're here. Let's have a look at the galaxy for where our next destination is. Sagittarius A. I believe. I've got that bookmarked as well. No. Or that's weird. I thought I had it bookmarked. Yeah, I have it bookmarked, so why isn't it? Excuse me. Okay, where is it? No. It's all the Galenia route. That's the system with Farseer. Okay, that's weird. So let's just use a search function. Mix it up. I always think it's two G's and one T. No, it's vice versa. It's two. Oh, I don't have it bookmarked. I have a system bookmarked. I have no idea what's there then. Okay. So. Another 10,000 light years to go. So, ladies and gentlemen, before we go, let's recap what we've done so far in the past 2 weeks. We started over there in the bubble in Seoul. We used this long row of bookmarks of the first week to get here to Colonia. And then over this past week, we went across the outer reach of the core, and we are now here. We are now going to set Darius. That's probably going to take another week, hopefully less than that. And from set Darius, we are going to Beale Point, which I have no idea how long that's gonna take because I've never been there. So, without further ado, incentive, I'm going, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.